Okay guys, so when you're in the preview state of your website, you can always go back to design so that we can continue designing the site. So what we've done so far is we've created a basic site with the regular default settings. We have done some custom effects such as drop shadow. We're in the master page and we created the top header using just we changed the size of it and we used a regular square. And then we've added our logo and our navigation, which right now aren't linked to anything, but that's okay because we don't have anything to link it to yet. So the next thing we want to do is we want to talk about the footer. So this is a sticky footer. It's at the bottom of the screen, so that's a good thing. And then if we come here, it says bottom of page, drag to adjust the minimum page size. So this can be dragged however you want it, and this might get longer depending on our content when we actually add it in here. So this down up here is the footer, so this is going to allow us to decide how big our footer should actually be. So I'm going to make mine about that big. I'll just kind of eyeball it and then see how I like it from there. So when I go to add the footer, what I need to do is I need to place the social icons as images. So I'm going to do that first before I actually add a background graphic. So I'll go to File, Place. Now the cool thing about Adobe Muse is I can come in here to my social icons folder, and here are all the social icons that I have, and I'm actually going to do them all, but remember you only need to do 3 at minimum. So I can highlight all of these and click open, and it's going to load those 7 files into my cursor. So I can click and drag so I can choose how big I want the icon to be. So you can barely see it, but it's giving me numbers in the bottom right hand corner. Or I can just click and it'll give me all the correct sizes, all the original sizes. So what I want to do is I want to then resize this. Now here's the thing about Adobe Muse. You're going to try to resize and you're going to automatically try to hold shift to make sure that it doesn't get skewed, which is a great thing. But Muse is backwards. Shift will allow you to skew it. If you don't hold shift, it automatically makes sure it's proportionally transformed. So I'm going to go through all of these, and I wish there was an easier way to do this, and if you guys find one. I want to make all of my icons 70%, so I could have, when I went to save it through Adobe Illustrator or whatnot, what I could have done is I could have saved it correctly then. See how it's just being crazy? Because it's trying to, like, whatever, we're just going to do 73 with everything for right now. See, it's just not being cool. There we go. It's trying to snap two different widths of things, and it's not doing very well. So anyway, once you get these all down to the size that you want them to, or maybe you didn't even have to worry, you can start putting all the icons down here. Now, when you put them down here, they're not actually in the footer. They look like they're in the footer, but they're not actually in the footer. So what we'll do right now is we'll just place them in there, and we will put them together and see how it gives you guides to show you when things are lined up. And then the cool thing is once you start putting your next icon, see how you can see this little 17 pixel that is happening here? It's trying to get you to evenly space these. Now what you can do, you can use the align panel, and that could make things a lot easier for you so you don't have to do it with each one of these, but I just wanted to show you that that was available to you. So for all of these, I can come in and now they are all evenly spaced and lined up correctly. So I can highlight them all and try to get them right in the center. And there we go. Now they're not actually in the footer, so with them all highlighted, see this little footer checkbox? Click that and then it makes it permanently in the footer. So that's important for template purposes. Then what I need to do is I need to add some text. So I can come in here and click and drag out this text box. And again, we want to just do regular font for right now. Copyright, and I think it was Option G on a Mac. And I can't remember what it was for a PC, so make sure to watch the first video. 2014 MCC Multimedia. And student name. So I can highlight all of this and I can center it, and I can make it 11-point font. And I'm actually going to make it white because I eventually want to put a square behind all of this. So I'm going to grab the square tool, or the rectangle tool, drag out a square, and then change the color of it. So it sort of coordinates with whatever is happening up here. So I could come up and find what this particular color is by using the eyedropper tool so that it coordinates. So the only problem here is that it's not arranged correctly. So I can either right click, go to arrange, send to back, or I can use the command key or the alt or control key on your keyboard and the two brackets to the right of the P key. That'll send things back or front using a keyboard shortcut. So once I've got it in there, I need to come and link all of these. So in the content.rtf file that I gave you that has all the content for the website, at the bottom you'll find the links. So what you'll want to do, I'll do WordPress because I know this one automatically. What you'll want to do is go to this add or filter links. So by clicking on it, I'll type in this full URL. Oops. And the reason why it's saying nothing found is because if you were typing to like Google, it recognizes Google because it's a popular site. So you could just click on it and it'd be fine. But just put the full URL and then hit enter and it's going to work. Now for each of these, you can come into the states and you can change what happens on the states. So on the rollover, let's say I wanted to add a glow. So I can come here and add a glow. And then on the mouse down, I can come here and add a glow again. Let's say I wanted it to be yellow, and that looks hideous, but you get what I'm saying. I'm just gonna do pink. And I'm gonna make it high opacity, and I'm gonna make it so it's a little bit easier to notice. So you'd have to do that with all of them. But now if I click preview, you want something to happen so that when people roll over it, it looks like something's happening or it's active. So I can click on that, and then when I click, see the down state, how it has that pink? So that's creating the bottom footer of our site, and it'll show you, it'll actually take you in the preview to that site. So I'll go back to design, and this is the final finished template. Then we can go in, and we can start editing our actual page and putting our content, but we'll save that for tomorrow.